All right, welcome back. Today we're going to be going over the Checkerd Sports tube chassis custom build. I think we started this back in, I want to say 2007. Never finished it. There's a lot of changes that I would like to make to it. But ever since then, you know, just been having fun with it. It is street legal. It is custom built by myself and Monzo Speed, which is Ansel up in Lake Tahoe. We kind of worked on it on and off here and there. We'd put it off for a year and then, you know, we'd kind of do a little bit here, a little bit there. So we're just going to be going through the car because I realized it never actually had any type of coverage and it's probably the funnest car I've ever driven. So we'll just go through everything and then we're going to go out for some test drives, even though it's really cold. So let's do it. All right. So as we were telling you, the car is custom built from the ground up. It is not an exoskeleton car or whatever you guys call those. This was a complete from scratch build. We had this on a big 5x10 metal table, probably tacked on there for a few years until we had a rolling shell. And as mentioned before, it is not finished. Never got to the panels. Did shake down at Thunder Hill. It was amazing. It needs panels. Mainly for the aerodynamics. So we'll just go through some of the components here. So starting from the front, we used a Riwire tucked radiator. Fits perfect right here in our area that we did. And then if you look under, this is actually a really hard find, but I used the Lotus Elise steering rack after doing a lot of research. That was one of the racks I found that is very, very, very light. So that's how right-hand drive came about because I had to flip the rack in order to use the S2000 knuckles since they're front steering and the Lotus Elise is a rear steering knuckle. So as you can see over here, we used S2000 knuckles, but we made our own arms, A-arms. And then originally we were going to do the gas tank behind the seat, but the problem with that is as soon as we dropped the engine in, we realized we needed more weight in the back, or sorry, in the front. So we just went with a basic aeromotive all-in-one stealth tank, which works actually really great. And of course, Volks on everything. We have C28s in the front and T37Vs in the back. With a 275, we'd like to get something a little beefier. Like I said, there's some changes that I want to make to it. So over here we have tilt and overhang pedals right here. And then I used a DC5 donor car for most of these cars, or sorry, these parts. So as some of you guys know, I used to import. So I just took one of those DC5s and used all the parts from it. So even kept the original cluster, which is kind of cool because it matches the engine. So moving on to the back, we have a K20A Type R. You can see here, it's a little bit dirty. Haven't really driven the car in a while. Obviously it's winter. And the first thing you see back here is a custom sheepy built header, or it's sheepy race now, I believe. This was so long ago, I think they were still sheepy built. So they built this custom exhaust manifold, and then it goes down into a burned stainless steel two-stage muffler, which keeps it actually pretty quiet. And then we have custom Penske shocks. Penske actually designed these for the car. You send them all the specs and they'll make you a custom shock for your car. For the drive shafts, we used Insane Shafts, really cool people. We sent them the specs and they made us custom shafts. And then the engine, there's obviously a lot of Checkerd Sports goodies and then custom parts, one-offs. Engine's really dirty. You can see Checkerd Sports EP3 AC pulley kit, fuel rail, fuel gauge. We used the RBC manifold.
And then down here, we have K Pro. Or sorry, no, actually that's not even the K Pro. I took the K Pro out, it's in my car. That's just a K20 Type R ECU right now. Fuel Lab components. So the radiator hoses, we actually had to make the pipes go all the way to the front. As you can see, they run down the center. And then we made a swirl pot tank that they come up to. Interior is pretty basic, two seats. The number one goal for this car was to drive it on the street. Don't see a reason of spending so much time and money on a car and not being able to drive it. So I think that's pretty much it for the rundown. A couple other Checkerd Sports goodies. I used the passenger plate. And then we run the PC680 battery. And of course the hybrid racing shifter. This is actually the OG V1 prototype hybrid racing shifter. Old school. All right, so we're gonna go for a little rip.
All right, so with the tube car, we always wear a full face just because there's so many things that can fly everywhere. Plus it's really cold. So we're just gonna do a quick drive down the street. We are in Mexico, by the way. This is Mexico.
We're in Mexico.
As you can hear, the Burns muffler keeps it toned down really well. It's a cold day out here. Did you hear my horn?
People are probably like, what the fuck?
Thank you. right, so this was Jose's first time riding in the tube car. What did you think?
This thing was crazy. It's crazy fast. It honestly kind of scared me for a second. I'm not gonna lie, like once you started getting in a high RPM, it started moving and it went up. The RPM, like the car went so fast, like in a, I don't know, it's crazy. Like it's like a go-kart on steroids, man. Like, I don't know, it was just something for sure that I ain't gonna forget, that's for sure. Like it's a totally a fun car for sure.
All right, so two thumbs up for sure.
Dude, if I had four, I'd give you four, bro. All
right, so that concludes the video of the tube chassis car. We felt like it should get documented since it's never been documented, and went for a quick ride along. So that's it, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you follow and like.